take a bite of the Big Apple on the USL Pro Game of the Week. It's FC New York against Antigua Barracuda FC, two new teams with the playoffs firmly in their sights. We'll show you what we're talking about here. While Orlando's running away with the American Division, Barracuda's hanging right in there in fourth place and can solidify that playoff place with a victory here tonight. Meanwhile, the National Division, Rochester's 3 points ahead of Harrisburg, but you see FC New York, an expansion team, doing very well in their first year in USL Pro. Hello again, everyone. I'm Ken Tomash, along with Keith Tabatsnik. Keith, an exciting matchup tonight with a lot to play for.
Yeah, we saw both teams are sitting in the fourth place in their divisions, but that's where the similarities end as of late. FC New York, the last six games, only one loss, but Antigua Barracuda, in the last seven games, only one win. They've given up 19 goals, have scored 23, an unpredictable team. We'll see which one shows up tonight. Both teams have a couple players that have to step up for their victory for their team.
That's right, and we'll take a look at FC New York's Steven Diaz, who has grabbed the starting goalkeeper role. He shut out the Richmond Kickers here a week ago, played very well in the Open Cup against the New York Red Bulls. His coach calls him a terrific shot stopper. Meanwhile, for Barracuda FC, their captain, George Dublin, returns from suspension, and his veteran presence at age 34 should help bring some stability to their back line. So the stage is set. We are at Belson Stadium at St. John's University in New York for the USL Pro Game of the Week here on Fox Soccer.
Legendary New York Cosmos are back, and to mark the club's rebirth, Umbro has applied its celebrated football tailoring ethos to the brand new 2011 collection. Anthem jacket, Cosmos tees, New York Cosmos jersey, 1976-1977 home jersey. For the complete New York Cosmos line, go to soccer.com/Umbro.
This program is brought to you by WorldSoccerShop.com. Follow World Soccer Shop on Twitter for special offers, coupons, product launches, and more.
New Hot Pocket Snackers, real restaurant-style flavors like loaded potato skins.
Hey, funky party people, are we having fun?
Any more restaurant and they'd come with an annoying waitress. New Snackers from
Hot Pockets.
So, the Hawaiian tropical pancakes are for the Georgia peach French toast are for the Texan Philly, and the Philly cheesesteak omelet is for the Hawaiian guy. I'll serve the rest. The California club salad for Virginia. Dakota, you got the southern shrimp and grits. And the Midwestern meat and potato sandwich for you, Carolina.
Oh, she's good.
Mary Lann, that right there.
Okay, La Homa.
Introducing the Tour of America menu. Open to flavors from all over the country, like the Hawaiian tropical pancakes. Denny's, America's diner, is always open.
You are watching FSC in HD. This summer, exclusive international rivalries are on Fox Soccer. Chelsea take on the best in Asia. The BPL compete against Hong Kong's first division. Man City and Inter square off in the Dublin Super Cup. Top BPL teams take on the MLS. Miss any of the action this summer only on Fox Soccer. Tomorrow, it's Soccer Night in America on Fox Soccer. The pressure is on as DC United look to rally up the Eastern Conference. Can Philly shut down the United Strike Force? DC United, Philadelphia Union, live tomorrow on Fox Soccer. You're watching FSC in HD.
This broadcast of USL Pro is brought to you by USLsoccer.com. Scores, stats, news, and more exclusively on USLsoccer.com, the official website of United Soccer Leagues. By Umbro, true to soccer since 1924. For more information, visit umbro.com. By the PDL, the Premier Development League, providing a pathway to the professional game. and by the W League, the first and longest running National Women's Soccer League in North America. July means summer, and it means summer friendlies. Coming up, Manchester United against Seattle Sounders FC, while Arsenal will take on the New York Red Bulls. It's all coming up here on Fox Soccer all this month. We are here at Belson Stadium at St. John's University in New York, and let's take a look at FC New York's lineup for Coach Paul Shaw. It's kind of a 4-3-3. Those wide midfielders will get forward. Owen Morrison scored a nice goal Tuesday in the Open Cup against Red Bull New York. For Antigua, Coach Tom Curtis playing out of a 4-4-2. Ron J. Christian, one of 11 national teamers for the Antigua Barbuda national team. Let's go now to our man in touch, former University of Maryland standout Jason Arnold. Who are you going to be looking at, Jason?
Today, Otero has been a big creator for FC New York. In his rookie year, he's leading the league with 5 assists. Keep an eye on him coming off the bench tonight and creating some opportunities for New York. For Antigua, keep an eye on Randolph Burton. 24-year-old has 3 goals and 1 assist in his last 5 matches, and he's been a huge threat for Antigua on the field.
That's right. Thank you, Jason. That is Etty Burton, and there is the FC New York huddle. Interim coach Paul Shaw's got FC New York playing quite well. Keith Tabatsnik, a longtime head coach at Georgetown University, is my partner this season, and Paul Shaw's done a nice job taking over a tough situation. He has them going 2-1-3 under his tutelage.
Well, it clearly shows that the players have bought into Paul right away, because he's very happy with how they've progressed. And, you know, just one loss in the last 6 games speaks a lot. They're, of course, still fighting, and, you know, and they're right in the middle of the season here, the 4th spot for the playoffs, and they're hoping for another big win tonight, but certainly Paul Shaw has done the work so far.
We are underway. It is Paul Shaw's FC New York team in the light blue jerseys, the blue socks and the white shorts, while Antigua Barracuda FC is in all black, and FC New York attacking from left to right. Here is Owen Morrison. Morrison marked on the far side by Orlando Mitchum. That one's a 50-50 ball here. And New York will continue to control. Stephen Roach. I'll chip this one. Jhonny Arteaga, he will turn and send a left footer that's blocked. Arteaga was looking for a handball. He's not going to get it. And Barracuda with their initial possession. Doesn't last very long. Stolen back by New York's Stephen Roach. Here comes Roach pushing forward, sending a right footer in the box, looking again for Arteaga. And it will go over the head of Barracuda's Christopher Harvey. And scooped up there by Cana De Castro. Castro sends this one long. They're trying to get it to Randolph Eddie Burden. Steven Diaz, who we talked about a moment ago in the open, got his first touch of the ball. And now FC New York will try to build out of the back once again. We're just in the second minute here. Sun setting over in the corner here at Belson Stadium on the campus of St. John's University. Play this one wide here to Michael Aquino. Captain Kyle Hoffer switches it to the far side. New York will send this one long again. And that will ride over the end line, but it'll be a goal kick. So initially, you can see some of that speed FC New York has up front with Arteaga and Morrison. And it's guys on the back line, like the ones you just saw, Christopher Harvey. And that man, Cana De Castro, will try to keep the New Yorkers off the board tonight.
Well, Ken, I think you're going to see a lot of those types of matchups. The pace on both ends is very good, and I think it's one of the things that could end up stretching the team's defenses, and we'll see which team can try to keep it compact while the other teams are trying to get in behind.
Artificial surface here at Belson Stadium, listed at 110 yards long, and 71 yards wide. So some of the speed on both these sides will be accented. It's Kwame Holder. That was picked off by George Dublin, who we talked about in the open as well. Their captain has returned from a 2-game suspension. Now it's Barracuda on the attack. They were onside, but again, that FC New York defense right there. Roach will play it here to Holder, but it's knocked out of play by Barracuda's Tamarly Thomas.
Well, you mentioned that FC New York, while maybe listed as a 4-4-2, really would be more of a 4-3-3. And Holder's one of the guys that definitely get forward. He plays in the center of the park a lot. Today he's starting out wide, and you're going to see him drifting up top and trying to become a third forward along with Jhonny Arteaga.
And Paul Shaw told us before the game that the biggest change that he made when he took over this team after a few games was just to have the players playing more positively. They've bought into the system, as you said, but just to have them go forward, play positively, try to get results, and it's working for him.
It is working, and certainly playing at home. He certainly wants to keep doing that here, playing at home on TV, and have the team really have build the confidence as they go in, because it's tough to get into these playoff spots.
This portion of the match brought to you by USLsoccer.com as that shot goes high and wide over the goal and into the seats. USLsoccer.com, the league's official website. Standing, scores, stats, and more, all on USLsoccer.com. Some of the crowd enjoying a beautiful evening here in New York on the first day of July. Fans of all ages turning out here. And if there's a weak part in Steven Diaz's game, you may have just witnessed it. Coach, no, Paul Shaw said that he's a good shot stopper, but his kicking occasionally lets him down, and that goal kick did not go as well as he would have liked. It's a turnover, and Barracuda FC has possession.
So, yeah, and Carson Smith, the American University graduate, just going right through the Antigua player. Talking about the issues with the goalkeeper and his feet, both keepers have had some issues this year, and doing some things with their feet that haven't been helping their team. And such an important part of the game if you're a goalkeeper nowadays. You have to be very good in your feet and safe as well.
There's Kamarley McDonald sending that one long. Again, they look for Randolph. Randolph now will turn and have a go, and that one gets blocked by Kyle Hoffer. Still alive, though, as Hoffer heads it back to his goalkeeper, Diaz.
We have Kyle Hoffer and Carson Smith pairing up in the center of the back. Two young center backs for FC New York. Hoffer from St. John's and Smith, you said, from American. And it's the spine and the backbone of the team. And Paul Shaw is going with these young guys, and he feels that they've done a great job of just going to get better and better.
Now it's Barracuda. We'll build out of the back, and they'll reverse it here to the near side. Kamarley McDonald. Pressure now put on by the forwards for FC New York. Try to get to Randolph. Randolph can't get back in play. Hoffer steals it away. Hoffer now, nice one-touch passing to Holder, but a nice slide tackle there, and that's the kind of play that George Dublin brings in his return to the first 11.
Yeah, they certainly missed him, as we said. Antigua has struggled in the last number of games. Last two games, they lost at home to Orlando City, leading the league, but one of the best things, the one win that they have had was at Orlando City. So they've certainly shown that they can do it against the top teams.
Yes, that 2-1 win snapped a long undefeated streak for Orlando City, and it was their first defeat at home. So this team can get it done. They've also won on the road at Los Angeles. So making a long trip to the mainland doesn't faze them. We'll see how they do in the first game of a two games in 3 days set here. They'll be in Pittsburgh on Sunday. Right now it's FC New York, though, with most of the possession in the early going. Again, they try to get to Eddie Burton, but Loach was all over him. You will see a lot of this. You will see FC New York build out of the back, knock it forward, headed back, though, by Barracuda. Roach comes in and gets a foot to it, gets it to the far side to Owen Morrison. Morrison in a battle there with Orlando Mitchum. Send it forward. Don Smart goes back. Eighth minute. Top of the box and headed back out of danger. Ball just bounces there on the turf and nobody seemed to want it. Barracuda finally clears to Ranjay Christian. Kyle Hoffer with some nice work to strip him of the ball.
Yeah, he did well there. He kept on his feet and didn't foul. It's the type of time you often do foul. It was a bad giveaway, though, right there by Roche.
That one eludes Ranjay Christian. Comes back to Steven Diaz. Come here to Kwame Holder. Now back into the middle of the park. bounce off referee Nabil Al Sadi. Barracuda has it. There's Dublin now. Puts this one forward. Now we see the speed of Eddie Burton. Again, New York's defense is right there. You see Michael Aquino. Now Roach, look down the right-hand side here as Holder pushes forward. 1v1 in the corner. Nice defensive work by Kamali McDonald and Alcater De Castro.
Well, one of the things with Antigua, sorry here, Ken, is as we look at this, it was good defending, keeping his feet, you know, and Kwame Holder's quite good, almost blocking that, but first defender there in a good spot. But one of the things has been for Antigua, just hold on while we see this attack.
Burton with a left-footed go just wide of the post.
We see just how quickly Antigua got down the field there with Burton getting a good shot off at his left foot. Just going at him, cuts inside, strikes that not far off at all. Burton with 3 goals and 1 assist on the year, and he shows his danger when he's going at you.
Just 24 years old. A lot of young players in this game.
When I had the chance to finish what I was saying, one of the things with Antigua is that while they've had a number of good games, they've had some very good play within games, they have had a tendency to make some bad defensive mistakes that they've been punished for this year. There's been some with the keeper, some bad back passes that have led to goals, and it's the one thing that they really have to nail down because they've given up 19 goals. They score, they can score, and that's a great thing. But giving up 19 goals is going to be tough to win consistently.
Again, Hoffer is there. Roach will play it up. It's a dangerous ball in the box. Two defenders are there. Attacker went down. Ball goes back to New York.
Yeah, another St. John's product, David Reed at the left back winning that ball. Unlucky at Arteaga going through, would have beat the offside line if that ball had made it between the defenders or over top. Arteaga was asking for it over top, but I think the better play would have been on the ground or on the carpet here. The balls you play in the air here, obviously you got to deal with the bounces as well.
Holder is calling for the ball here on the right side. And he couldn't keep that one in play as Roach hit him along the sideline. And Kwame Holder couldn't hold her inbounds there.
Stephen Roach is a type of player that, you know, he's generally the good tackler and defender. He's trying to open up the game there. His partner in the back there, Aquino's a guy that can really open up with those balls.
Thomas with a high boot. And Roach will leave that one there for Kyle Hoffer. Now Hoffer will drill this one long. Here's Don Smart, the edge of the box.
Don Smart, he's only played in one game so far, kind of made his way in here, you know, with some impressive play with, you know, some of the practices and reserves and trying to get in behind. He's got some pace, he does like to go forward, and he's in there for his attacking abilities to try to join in as three up top the way that Paul Shaw would like them to do tonight.
And Coach Shaw is without his leading goal scorer, Graciano Brito, is out with a knee injury and has been for the last few weeks. But he does have options, including Jhonny Arteaga, who shoots and scores! Off the post, slowly and in, and FC New York appears to have taken the lead.
And we have another look at it. Look at that cross, and the keeper has started to come out, and then he stopped. And there was bad communication there, bad decision making by the goalkeeper. He really had to just go right at that ball, and he could have, if nothing else, he would have been right on top of the shot there. But well finished, just touched by the keeper as he's that rushing out. Jhonny Arteaga with his third goal of the season.
A local player, played in the PDL for the Westchester Flames. He said he was thrilled Tuesday night to play against the New York Red Bulls at Red Bull Arena in the US Open Cup. He's offside here, being a local player and getting a chance to show his stuff in front of the home folks, and he puts his side on top in the 14th minute with his third goal of the year.
He does, and I'll tell you, playing against the Red Bull, Owen Morrison gave them a thrill for a while. They're putting them on the lead with an outstanding shot from second range, and unfortunately, possibly still celebrating when Red Bull equalized it.
And that's exactly what Paul Shaw said before the game. They have a tendency to do, they'll get a goal and then concede one. So these next few minutes here are going to be very important for them, as they've just taken the lead, and we know that Barracuda can score some goals, so next few minutes, we'll see how Barracuda responds.
And Ken, it's certainly something we hear all the time from our coaches is, how important the couple minutes are right after a goal for both teams. And the reason they say it is because so often goals are scored back to back, or, you score your second one as well, as we foul right in the midfield.
Kimoy Alexander goes down. Quentin Griffith looks to be one option here on this free kick. They've got several of them. To Marley Thomas, standing over the ball at the moment. Alexander is there as well. And now as the sun almost goes down over on the far side, it's not gonna be an issue for Diaz, but it might actually be in the eyes of the Barracuda players as they attack from right to left here in the first half.
I'll tell you what, if they get somebody that is gonna take a shot on goal from here, then they've got someone that can hit quite a ball. That's a distance here, isn't it?
Yeah, it's about 40 yards probably, maybe more. Now, finally, we're ready to go. Drilled, and wow! Maybe they do have somebody who can strike it from that distance.
I was testing them there.
Wow, Diaz, just watched that one go just wide of the post, but that was a bullet.
I think somebody yelled out to him, they said you can't do it.
It's Marley Thomas.
He did it, Rock. I mean, I will say, if you can beat a keeper from there, the problem could be on the keeper's end.
Now Holder plays that one square. Dangerous ball in the middle. Roach with a nice tackle. They get it back to New York.
So nothing much good comes off square balls very often. Right there was wasn't any sharpness to that pass. And it's one of the areas that he has to get better. He's good at the dribble and some things coming off the dribble, but just connecting.
Roach sends that one long, looking for Smart. Arteaga, the goal scorer.
That's another ball. If Morrison could have played that behind the defender, he had David Reed going forward.
Arteaga will rip this one, and he scores again. Under the crossbar and down for another goal. Jeff Hurst just called. He said, nice goal.
Absolutely. Absolutely, but there was no questioning with that, with the lines, with the assistant referee on if that ball went in. Look at this shot, guys. We got an early candidate for goal of the year, an early candidate for player of the game. And unlike with Jeff Hurst's shot, this is clearly over the line. What a strike. You could read the writing on that ball.
This is your man of the first 18 minutes of this match. His third and fourth goals of the year. That one, a memorable strike. This portion of the broadcast brought to you by Umbro, true to soccer since 1924. For more information, visit umbro.com. Well, this game with FC New York leading 2-0 comes at the end of a memorable week for the guys in blue. We'll get down to Jason Arnold in just a second for a little more on that, but here come the New Yorkers looking for more. And that one will go wide. So let's go down to Jason now for more on the big week for FC New York.
Yeah, FC New York's had a very memorable week. They played the New York Red Bull in the third round of the Open Cup, and they competed very well with the MLS team. They were actually leading in the second half. Red Bull came back, they put two in, and they got the 2-1 victory. But USL Pro's Richmond Kickers, they've actually done one better. They beat the Columbus Crew 2-1. They're now going to advance in the fourth round of the Open Cup, and they're playing Sporting Kansas City.
Yeah, the Richmond Kickers are carrying the flag for USL Pro, and even the losses by USL teams, Orlando City, the LA Blues, and the Rochester Rhinos, only lost by a single goal. Here's the short corner, into Smart, into the box. Headed goalward, headed out. It's going to be a second corner, it looks like. Started to say, just to finish that thought about an impressive performance by USL Pro teams in the Open Cup. Watch this, how close this comes here.
You know, again, bad communication with the goalkeeper and defender.
And again, this is why George Dublin is so important to that back line. As you can see, a veteran of the Antigua and Barbuda national team. So it'll be a second corner, this time from the other side. Again sent into the box and again sent back out, but still in play. Here's Owen Morrison. Morrison, that's punched out. Still dangerous though. Barracuda trying to clear. They're down 2-0 now. But here they come on the attack. Trying to stay onside. Quentin Griffith played that ball in. Now that one will go to the edge of Diaz's box. It took a hop and went almost over his head. Just to finish the thoughts, I mean, the Open Cup was impressive. Yep. It's impressive, obviously, that Richmond is still alive. Great win over Columbus Crew and the one-goal losses and the tough play by USL Pro teams. To strengthen the fact that USL Pro is the strongest, most sophisticated, most experienced North American men's pro soccer league below MLS, both on and off the field. And the MLS guys got a good taste of that.
Yeah, tell the team, the games, they all had their hands full, and it really is a credit to Richmond, Lee Calishaw and his team, you know, for advancing, and certainly good luck.
You're Smart. And a long blast into Castro. Fortunate that that didn't take a wild hop.
You know, one of the things about these games when they're playing the MLS team, that these MLS teams want to win these. It's not like they're playing the reserve sides against the USL teams. They're playing their top players and, you know, trying to go for the win. There's a lot on the line to win the Open Cup. And, you know, again, really good credit, competitive games. And, you know, hopefully Richmond can continue to carry the flag.
We'll be in Richmond next week to see the Kickers against the hot Charlotte Eagles. But here we are at Belson Stadium in Jamaica, New York. 21st minute. And the home team, FC New York, leads Antigua Barracuda 2-0. But Barracuda have a deep throw in. Thrown into the box. And tons of blue shirts there. Griffith lost that one. It's put up and over the bar by Kamoy Alexander.
That's Alexander, a bit casual on the shots. Had a shot earlier in the game, too. And you know, really had plenty of time to let that ball drop down a little bit and get a solid hit. And they can't, just because it's 2-0, feel like, hey, you know, the game's lopsided.
Most dangerous lead in soccer, my friend. As you know, as a coach, I'm sure it's happened to you before.
You know, I did, but when I was winning 1-0, I didn't mind going to that dangerous lead.
You'll take it.
But the truth is, the mentality, you know, it is a difficult time with a 2-0 lead.
It's Barracuda looking to cut into that lead. It's Ranjay Christian down in the corner. Alexander lost it. Kwame Holder now with it in midfield. Now Roach. Arteaga made a run. Now Holder slides that one forward. Oh, and Eric Rengifo pushing up from right back. Got forward and couldn't keep that one in.
Yeah, and I tell you, it's encouraging to see him go forward like that as well. And that was an excellent pass. In fact, you know, on a grass field, that slows that pass down right into his run. You know, one of the things on this field, the ball will run away from you a little bit more. But that's what Paul Shaw wants, is wide backs getting forward in it.
Here's a chance for Barracuda. Left-footed shot just wide of the post by Eddie Burton. You saw how elusive and how dangerous Randolph Eddie Burton can be.
And we'll have another look. And, you know, here's this, but the ball bouncing around. David Reed couldn't quite get a foot on it. And Carson Smith steps up, but the shot does go around. And that was a, you know, that's an excellent chance for them to cut that lead right in half.
Well, we want to welcome everybody watching us on the islands. We understand that Fox Soccer is very popular in Antigua and Barbuda. And so we know you're proud of your team. They've been really one of the success stories of the 2011 season on and off the field. We told you they won at Orlando. They won at Los Angeles. And they're right there looking for a playoff berth in their first season in the league. And there's thousands of fans at the Sticky Wicket Stadium. It's a real festival atmosphere down there. I've heard it's the best pitch in the league. And they really have a great time.
Well, you know, they love their football down there. And, you know, one of these things with the Antigua Barracudas is having so many players on this team that also play for the national team. You know, it gives them it's a double hit with them, because it's almost like training for the national team. And, you know, a lot of credit there to Gordon Derrick, who's Barracuda FC's chairman. He's also the general secretary of Football Association in Antigua. We've got to be quite a powerful man there, and he's got to be very proud of having his team in USL Pro.
Well, they also get great support from Antigua and Barbuda Football Association President Everton Gonzalez. His team now is on the attack, and it's broken up there. And the Prime Minister Baldwin Spencer also supports this team quite a bit. We hope he's watching tonight. They love their football and their cricket in Antigua, and they've got great facilities down there, impressive fan support. And they're definitely a team to watch, and they'll be trying to get back into this match down 2-0 thanks to two goals by Jhonny Arteaga. And they are looking for more. Holder flicks it back out to Rengifo. They tried to slide that one through, and it'll be cleared out of play here on the near side.
Cleared out by Kamali McDonald. He's actually done a good job in that one-on-one defending versus Holder. It's going to be an interesting matchup during the course of the game.
Roach floats this one to Smart at the top of the box. Roach will have a go, and it's grabbed out of the air by DeCastro. This portion of the match brought to you by the Premier Development League, providing a pathway to the professional game. Five of Paul Shaw's 11 starters played in the PDL. Here is Barracuda again on the attack. It's Kyle Hoffer, one of those former PDL players, clearing that one out of the box with his head. It's Tamarly Thomas now, sliding that one across, and it'll go over the end line. So Barracuda's getting forward, getting some chances. They're not.
There's no question this is a very open-ended field for both teams right now. And I think that the concern I would have on Paul Shaw is that when his team does get the ball, they need to start building a little bit of possession, a little bit of a rhythm here with a 2-0 lead, and force Antigua to chase them. And then things open up. The last thing they can do is really get in a bad number situation defensively and, you know, give up a goal when they're really in control on the scoreboard.
That's Eric Rengifo. Back to Kyle Hoffer. The 27th minute. Launch that ball long, and Arteaga is not going to be able to run onto it before it gets to Cater to Castro. Now here's Dublin. Near side, Kamali McDonald. Dublin pushes that one forward. Pretty sure that Christian was offside anyway. He came back.
And I think that's why he stopped instead of going after that ball, is he kind of knew why he was that wide open.
Hoffer. Oh, sorry.
I'm sorry. Okay. I'm just going to say that neither team is really compacting this field defensively very well. There's quite a bit of space to play in. And I think, you know, either team starts stringing some passes together, they're going to really open up some opportunities. And, you know, rather than trying to some of them get forward so quickly.
Thrown into Arteaga. Spins around McDonald, gets to the byline, but it's deep in the corner. Kwame Holder. Rengifo to Hoffer. A lot of the possession of this game, at least the long stretches of possession, have been in the Antigua end. Sent into the box, and Smart tried to run onto it, but DeCastro was there.
Yeah, very hard ball to connect with, going straight down the middle on here. That pop on this ground will certainly favor the goalkeeper coming out. And of course, this time the goalkeeper did come out the whole way. And you know, as we saw in the first goal, he hesitated in the middle there. And, you know, it's usually disaster when you do that.
There you saw Tom Curtis, longtime player at Chesterfield in England. We've got two English managers going head to head in this match. Paul Shaw, of course, played for a little club we like to call Arsenal, as well as some others. He's a bit of a goal scorer in his career as well, and his team has two of them here through the first 28 minutes and change, both from that man, Jhonny Arteaga.
In fact, Paul Shaw scored quite a number of goals for Millwall after leaving Arsenal.
And Gifo has that one drop over the head of Arteaga. Now a spring in the step of Barracuda. Off to the races is Orlando Mitchum. Mitchum will left foot this one across. It goes off Hoffer's head. Kept alive at the top of the box. Griffith plays it. Alexander had that one go off his boot and will go out of play on the far side.
The FC New York dodged a bullet there because defending on the right side, Eric Rengifo, again in his first start out from Hofstra University, kind of dove in at that ball, allowing the player to get by him, and he really just needed to contain. But certainly, if you're going to go in for it, you got to get something. You can't have the ball and the player go by you.
One or the other, not both.
Yes.
Now the sun has dropped. It's dusk here. A beautiful night in New York. Almost reached the 30-minute mark here on the USL Pro Game of the Week. Ken Tomasz, Keith Tabatsnik, and Jason Arnold with you from Belson Stadium on the campus of St. John's University. And FC New York, two goals to the good, but Barracuda looking to get something here with only 15 minutes left before halftime. And they've had some chances. Definitely have been pushing forward. But FC New York's possession game has made those opportunities come kind of staccato-like. This one's over the top, looking for Arteaga. DeCastro couldn't use his hand, so he headed it out, but Kwame Holder kept it there. More Alexander. Is it the far side? They go inward to Griffith. Again, they look forward for Burton. Three blue shirts just collapsed on Burton as soon as he got the ball.
And that was the first time Antigua had, you know, a fair bit of little possession there and got a little bit of a rhythm. The final pass was off. And, you know, FC New York, you said, having the ball more. A dangerous pass there. A square ball again.
Here come the Barracuda. Kept alive nicely by Orlando Mitchum, but outstanding defending by FC New York.
You know, we're going to see Mitchum come in again. He's going right, but he got that ball off a square pass by Roach. Just going right at him, make it or break it right here, and almost did. Hoffer with an excellent slide tackle and ends up going off of Mitchum for the goal kick. But that was, again, just a, you know, unforced error in the midfield.
Great defensive work by that man, the captain, Kyle Hoffer, whose sister, Caitlin, is actually on our production crew tonight and quite the player herself. So Big Brother may have bragging rights for tonight, though, as that was a very nice play, and his team is up 2-0.
Is that why we're seeing a lot of close-ups of him? You know, his sister getting some input there.
Oh, he's right there. You can't miss him, number four in blue. He's in the midst of everything on that back line as they send that one to the top of the box. Griffith heads that one over. Team defense seems to be key here for New York. They get a lot of guys back, not just their back four. It seems like everybody gets back and helps out.
Yeah, they are. In many ways, you know, they leave you know, one player up top defensively with Jhonny Arteaga, and the rest do drop back. Having said that, there's still enough space in here that if Antigua gets a little sharper, they'd be able to do a couple 1-2s and then play through for the speed that they have. And I think that they're dangerous there. They can easily get in behind if they're patient.
Well, the magic of television, Keith. Two goals here tonight. The other three games in USL Pro this evening are scoreless. Second half in Pittsburgh with Orlando and the Riverhounds. LA at Charleston, also scoreless at the half. And Rochester and Richmond at Salem Stadium. We will be in Richmond next Friday night as the Kickers host the Charlotte Eagles. Here it's 2-0 New York. Arteaga heads that one on.
Say our USL powers that be know how to pick the games. Picked an excellent one last week, and you know, another one here, and we hope to see more goals in this game. I, you know, love the goals to be rolling in, and both teams kind of feeling on the attack.
I'm sure the folks watching in the islands are with you on that one, my friend.
They want it. Well, Antigua can score 23 goals. You know, clearly they know how to get forward, and you know, watch some clips. And if you want to see some entertaining clips, go online to USL and get some of the videos and the clips that they have of the various games that have been played. But there's some really good ones with Antigua in there.
That's right. You can watch more than 100 games on USLLive.com, as well as our comprehensive broadcast package here on Fox Soccer with the game of the week. We're bringing you right now and every weekend. And USL Breakaway Magazine. It all lets you fans get close to the passion, excitement, and tradition that lives in USL Pro. Had a lot of excitement in this game already. In the 34th minute. This portion of the match brought to you by the W League, the first and longest running National Women's Soccer League in North America. Just one of the properties, and maybe those young ladies will grow up to play in the W League.
Well, you'd have to say if they do, maybe they feel that their chances of playing in a World Cup are quite high. There's quite a number of players in the current World Cup going on in Germany went through the W League. It's actually, you know, I think it's like more than 60 of the players. Quite an impressive statistic. And certainly some of our stars, Abby Wambach, Shannon Box, Heather O'Reilly, Carly Lloyd, Alex Morgan, to name some of them.
And we'll talk more about the W League with USL Senior Director of the W League, Amanda Duffy, at halftime. Right now we want to go to Jason Arnold, who's getting a first-hand look at this terrific crowd here on a gorgeous night at St. John's. Jason?
Yeah, it's a pretty energetic crowd here tonight at Belson Stadium, and attendance has been really strong throughout USL Pro this season. Orlando's led the way with crowds of 8,000 or so at the Citrus Bowl. Wilmington Hammerheads, Charleston Battery, Rochester Rhinos, and the Richmond Kickers, they've enjoyed crowds of 5,000 or better. Now those numbers, they're just gonna get better as we get closer to the playoffs, and those games are gonna become more and more significant, so hopefully they'll draw some fans out and keep these crowds coming.
Well, and here in New York, as you might expect, is a very diverse crowd. The folks here marketed to throughout the greater New York area. Got to give credit to Doug Peterson and Joel and Treiber. They've done a great job marketing the club to all the ethnic fan bases who have a team here in one of the five boroughs to call their own. And they're seeing their team up 2-0, but here's Barracuda looking to cut that lead in half. It's Eddie Burton. And there you see Diaz quick with his feet. Could have pounced on that ball or cleared it, and he cleared it.
Yeah, he cleared it. He played it the safe way. I think it was a good decision. You know, the ball's popping through. They'll have another look at this. Just a cutback here. Turned Hoffa the wrong way, and I think a very good decision by Diaz. Just get that ball out of there. You can discuss later whether it was the right thing to do. Just get it out of danger.
Burton, definitely a handful. Now here's Alexander. Griffith drops it forward. Alexander on the run, and they all meet there right at the edge of the six-yard box.
Well, Alexander started that play. Good ball, and just kept his run going. He was not tracked through the midfield by the FC New York defenders, and a better pass could have put him right one-on-one to goal.
Arteaga does that one go off his chest, but he works hard to try to get it back, and his team does have it back. It's Michael Aquino.
You know, Ken, I think one thing that FC New York has to be very careful about is the fact that they may be up 2-0. You know, one of the goals off the cross and probably a mistake by the goalkeeper, some poor communication, and of course the other goal, just an absolutely outstanding strike from second distance. So it hasn't been a lopsided game.
Oh, not at all. Possession-wise, FC New York has had possession, but Barracuda's gotten their chances, and you can see the quality of guys like Eddie Burton and Ronjay Christian getting forward.
You know what it is, they're dangerous. It's just the words that, you know, when they're running forward with the ball, going at players, they are tough to mark.
And you see Randolph Eddie Burton as Owen Morrison goes to take this corner. Third corner of the night, they went short in the first couple. This one's chipped to the six, headed back the other way, but it'll be held in by New York. Now Morrison going 1v1 at the edge of the box. Chips it inward. Arteaga thought he may have been able to get his third, but he puts it over the bar. And why?
Again, it was Don Smart keeping that ball in play when the ball was headed out. Was able to get it, and almost Arteaga almost getting on the end of the cross by Morrison. And Morrison, after he played the corner, a lot of people play the corner and watch it. He got back out into a good position to be open for the second chance in.
You saw the smile there from Arteaga. A striker can smile when he's already got two in the back tonight. If he misses one, he can smile about it. Foul call on the far side there. So you look at Tamarly Thomas. And we're here to Aquino. Mike to Rengifo, loose ball, scooped up by Barracuda. Here's Griffith now. Slide this one forward. And Hoffer again there to head it back to his keeper, Steven Diaz.
And Griffith is one of the guys that they play through a lot. He's got four assists for Antigua. He's also one of these guys, played with the national team, had eight caps, one goal.
Dublin heads that one forward. Smart gets a touch to it. And Barracuda will reset. Long ball driven out of the back. And Hoffer again heads it back to his keeper. We're in the 40th minute. Lovely night in New York City. And FC New York up 2-0 on Antigua Barracuda FC. On the USL Pro Game of the Week here on Fox Soccer. Karsten Smith plays it. Kyle Hoffer. Again, the possession by FC New York. And Barracuda looking to come up with a turnover and get a counter going quickly. Over Arteaga's head, and back the other way by Barracuda. Morrison takes the throw on the far side. Tried to switch it here to the near side, but it's mishit, out of play. It'll give New York a chance.
And the thing about that, Ken, is even if that ball connected, he's putting his teammate in under tremendous pressure to have to bring that ball down with players getting at him.
There's Hoffer now. Karsten Smith. And again, Barracuda swoops in for the turnover, starts the counter. It's Griffith on the run. He's burning through a couple of defenders. Goes down and the New Yorkers have it back.
You know, again, that was a situation, Karsten Smith going forward, playing the ball and continuing to go there without really good cover behind him. And you know, he's a center back, he's a young player, but you gotta be a little safety conscious right now, especially in these last minutes with a 2-0 lead. And I like him, I saw him play in college at American University, and you know, his coach Todd West loved the way that he was just a very reliable defender. And likewise with Hoffer, played here at St. John's for Davey Mazur. Two guys that really had very good college careers. And Paul Shaw is very happy with them right now as the backbone of their defense.
Well, speaking of college careers, I mean, yours was legendary for 22 years as the head men's coach at Georgetown, and you have some unfortunate memories of this place. I hate to bring it up, but we are here at St. John's.
Every time I drive up to this place, I get the chills or the shivers or something like that. This was an incredibly difficult place to win at, and we proved that correct too many times when we came up here. But I love the rivalry, a lot of respect for Dave Mazur and the program he developed, and this place that he really built. They used to play on a old turf field, the old football field. And this place was built, and what a great atmosphere they bring.
Yeah, terrific facility, and the crowd really into it now. With their team leading, thanks to that man, Arteaga, who tries to run onto this one, but George Dublin is there, a dangerous back pass. Let me put some mustard on that one.
Tell you what, he's testing his keeper, wasn't he?
He's liable to hear about that one when they go in at the interval here, with just a few minutes left. Mitchum now. Looking for a bit of magic. Will it come from Orlando Mitchum here on the left wing?
will send it into the six. Diaz punches it out. Collision with an attacking player. Griffith has it back. He wants to have a go, but lots of light blue shirts there. They strip him of the ball, come back the other way. Arteaga trying to remain onside.
Yeah, I mean, a good decision again by Diaz in the goal. And there's an Antigua player down in the 18 right now. And we go back down to it. But Diaz, one of the knocks on him is sometimes he holds his line too much. And certainly that time, a very good decision to punch it out.
Kimura Alexander begs to differ.
We'll have a look at this again. Coming out, and certainly they've gotten a little bit of collision there. Looks like I might have got a little bit of the goalkeeper glove into the face.
You see Nabil Al Sadi, our referee tonight, as the athletic training staff will come out to have a look at Kimura Alexander.
Have another look at this. As the cross comes in. This was a good cross. I mean, you talked about trying to test the goalkeeper, and it was the face right into the shoulder, and that will sting for sure. But again, Antigua showing their presence, trying to get forward, and I'd be surprised if they don't find a goal in this game. They've had plenty of opportunities and half chances.
Well, not only the folks watching back in the islands on Fox Soccer, but there's some folks from Antigua here in the crowd tonight at Belson Stadium, as obviously there's a lot of folks from the islands here in greater New York area showing their pride. There are some of their flags, the first professional sports team from the Leeward Islands of the Caribbean to compete in the North American National League. And I really would like to go there one time, because I've heard that this is one of the top vacation and honeymoon destinations. They've got great beaches, reefs, friendly population,
and they have the Sticky Wicket.
The Sticky Wicket Stadium.
Sticky Wicket Stadium.
So if you're here in New York or anywhere, if you want to take a look about tourism to Antigua and Barbuda, visit www.antigua-barbuda.org. That's the Antigua and Barbuda Department of Tourism, which has an office here in the New York area.
And I think we'll certainly lobby for a Fox Soccer USL Pro game down there.
Get on the boat. Have a nice slow cruise. We are quickly approaching the end of the first half here. We are in first half stoppage time with FC New York in blue, leading Antigua Barracuda FC 2-0. Kyle Hoffer now brings it up as New York tries to protect this lead here in the dying seconds of the first half.
I'll say New York, partially deserving this 2-0 lead, but at the same time, I think they've given up too many quality opportunities for Antigua that they really have to be careful. Antigua definitely can get a goal if it keeps being that loose in the back.
Arteaga pushes that one forward. Kino cannot keep it in. It was just that 3-minute stretch in the first half where Arteaga scored two goals in the 14th and 17th minutes, and we are into 3 minutes of stoppage time here. Still have just under 2 minutes left in it. Can Barracuda find something before the intermission? Push Mitchum into it. Ball back on his back line. Back up there, grabbed in the midfield by Barracuda. There's Mitchum. It's Marley Thomas. Couldn't find anybody to switch it to, so he just played it into the midfield to Kimura Alexander, who has returned after being shaken up. And that one will go wide of Steven Diaz's goal.
And Don Smart there definitely overplayed defensively. There's just no need to try to go for that ball in the last seconds of this half. Stand up the Antigua attacking player, and he has to play back. No danger.
Final minute of first half stoppage time. Get it to Arteaga. He's drifted back to the midfield stripe, and he gets fouled. This free kick may eat up the remaining seconds here in the first half of play.
So I'll go out on a limb and say that Arteaga is going to be the first half player of the match.
At least, player of the first 45 minutes. But as we know, matches are 90 minutes long, sometimes more. And in the dying seconds of the first half, Barracuda looks to get on the board. Griffith with a left footer. It's ripped over the stands behind Steven Diaz's goal. And that will probably get us to halftime as Nabil Al-Sadi checks his watch. He's going to wait for Steven Diaz to put his foot to this for some reason. And just as Diaz hits it, that's the end of the first half. Well, a brilliant stretch of 3 minutes early in this match saw Jhonny Arteaga score twice, the second one a rocket off the underside of the crossbar. And FC New York leads Antigua Barracuda FC 2-0 on the USL Pro Game of the Week. Stay with us. Our halftime show's coming up next.
Go to worldsoccershop.com today. Go to worldsoccershop.com today. Worldsoccershop.com is... Go to worldsoccershop.com today. Worldsoccershop.com. Colors of your country. Show off the crest of your club. Go to worldsoccershop.com today. Worldsoccershop.com is the destination for all your soccer needs. This summer... Worldsoccershop.com. Powered by passion.
New Hot Pocket Snackers. Real restaurant-style flavors like loaded potato skins.
Hey, Funky Party people, are we having fun?
Any more restaurant and they'd come with an annoying waitress. New Snackers from...
Hot Pockets.
Also get a free flight.
You know that comes with a private island.
Really?
No, it comes with a hat. You see, airline credit cards promise flights for 25,000 miles, but...
There's never any seat for 25,000 miles.
Frustrating, isn't it? But that won't happen with the Capital One Venture Card. You can book any airline, anytime. Hey, I just said that. After all, isn't traveling hard enough?
Ow. To get the flight you want, sign up for a Venture Card at CapitalOne.com.
What's in your wallet? It's okay. I've played a pilot before.
Nature Valley sweet and salty nut bars. They're made from whole roasted nuts and dipped in creamy peanut butter, making your craving for a sweet and salty bar irresistible by Nature Valley.
So, the Hawaiian tropical pancakes are for the Georgia peach, Georgia peach French toast are for the Texan Philly, and the Philly cheesesteak omelet is for the Hawaiian guy. I'll serve the rest. The California club salad for Virginia. Dakota, you got the southern shrimp and grits. And the Midwestern meat and potato sandwich for you, Carolina.
Oh, she's good.
Maryland, that right there.
Okay, La Homa.
Introducing the Tour of America menu. Open to flavors from all over the country, like the Hawaiian tropical pancakes. Denny's, America's diner, is always open.
Tomorrow, it's soccer night in America on Fox Soccer. The pressure is on as DC United look to rally up the Eastern Conference. Can Philly shut down the United Strike Force? DC United, Philadelphia Union, live tomorrow on Fox Soccer.
Is it so wrong for man to love cars? In some states, maybe. But I don't care. I'm a gearhead. That's why I'm hosting the Car Show, where we talk, live, and breathe everything cars.
The Car Show, coming July 13th to Speed.
You are watching FSC in HD.
The broadcast of this match is authorized by United Soccer Leagues. Any rebroadcast, retransmission, or other use of any image, sound, account, or description without the express written permission of USL is strictly prohibited. Tonight's match was produced for USL by Cultural Global Media Incorporated. It's halftime in New York. FC New York leads Antigua Barracuda FC 2-0 on the USL Pro Game of the Week. You know, there's a strong USL W League presence here in the greater New York area as well. Not only the Long Island Rough Riders and New York Magic battling it out in the Northeast Division. Three New Jersey-based squads in the Rangers, Wildcats, and Valkyries. 2017 league that spans North America and into Canada.
has produced more than 60 players who are participating in the FIFA Women's World Cup that's going on right now, including U.S. stars like Abby Wambach, Shannon Box, and Alex Morgan. And Canada's Christine Sinclair and Mexico's Monica Ocampo have also starred in the tournament to this point. We asked USL Senior Director of the W League, Amanda Duffy, about what is so special about the W League.
The W League showcases players from around the world, and this year in the 2011 season alone, we have more than 25 countries represented in this season with our W League teams. With the Women's World Cup, the W League influence has been apparent with the announcements of the final rosters for the 16 nations competing. And after the final rosters were revealed last week, we now know there are more than 60 players representing 10 different countries in the Women's World Cup this year. So it's just a testament to the ownership we have, the quality of the competition in the W League, and the quality of the reputation of the league itself. And we expect our global player reach to grow as the league itself grows. USL is the only organization in North America that offers a structure for the female player to progress all the way through our youth development programs in the Super Y League and Super 20 League that influence the players as early as the under 12 age group all the way through an under 20 age group, and then culminate in the W League. Having elite clubs within our programs, and also having naming national champions through postseason playoff formats, through distinct national championship finals, helps to allow clubs and players alike evaluate the development of each of those organizations and players. On an individual level, through ODP and through our W League Combine, we are able to select players based on performance within their respective teams and invite them into these programs where they're able to be evaluated and play in front of women's national team coaches as well as women's professional soccer coaches and scouts. With the influence that Peter Meller has had since he's been named the national technical director, he's enhanced these programs by improving the facilities that these programs are held at, raising the level of the coaches that are directly in contact with the players, and significantly improving the opportunity for the player that attends this event. So we've had and will continue to have the best programs for the female player to guide them through their player development and playing careers while staying in the USL structure. Having said that, when you think about a complete pyramid, which we offer on the men's side of the program with Super Y League, Super 20 League, USL PDL, and USL Pro, there is one level above the W League that we are actively and aggressively working to add so that we can offer that complete program and complete pyramid to the women's female player also.
And the W League Championship comes your way here on Fox Soccer on Sunday, July 31st at 7 Eastern from Seattle, Washington. Also this summer, we will bring you the PDL Championship on Saturday, August 6th. Check your local listings for that. Who will dethrone the defending league champion, Portland Timbers U23s? We'll find out on August 6th. Next up for us, next Friday night, we'll be in Richmond as the Kickers take on the red-hot Charlotte Eagles. That's at 8 o'clock Eastern Time, live here on Fox Soccer. We're going to step aside for just a second, but when Keith and I come back, we'll have highlights and stats from the first half. You won't want to miss watching Jhonny Arteaga's two goals. It's 2-0 at the half. Stick around.
The legendary New York Cosmos are back, and to mark the club's rebirth, Umbro has applied its celebrated football tailoring ethos to the brand new 2011 collection. Anthem jacket, Cosmos tees, New York Cosmos jersey, 1976-1977 home jersey. For the complete New York Cosmos line, go to soccer.com/Umbro.
When fire was discovered, people got together. Then they invented the wheel. More people got together. To get together at night, they invented light. And over a century ago, we invented Bacardi to bring it all together.
Nature Valley's sweet and salty nut bars. They're made from whole roasted nuts and dipped in creamy peanut butter. Making your craving for a sweet and salty bar irresistible by Nature Valley.
Could switching to Geico really save you 15% or more on car insurance? What, do you live under a rock?
No way. Hey, Rick, check this out.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
The biggest night of the summer is only on Fox. It's the 2011 All-Star Game in primetime. It all begins with the world premiere preview of Simon Cowell's The X Factor. Then, baseball's biggest stars take center stage for the Midsummer Classic.
Come on, come on, come on.
The 2011 All-Star Game, live July 12th, 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific, only on Fox.
This summer, exclusive international rivalries are on Fox Soccer. Chelsea take on the best in Asia. The BPL compete against Hong Kong's first division. Man City and Inter square off in the Dublin Super Cup. Top BPL teams take on the MLS. Don't miss any of the action this summer, only on Fox Soccer.
Welcome back to Belson Stadium, St. John's University, everybody. Ken Tomasz, Keith Dubetsnik with you on the USL Pro Game of the Week. New York leads Antigua Barracuda 2-0. Easy to pick out the highlights in the first half here.
Yeah, absolutely. Jhonny Arteaga show, and we see it right here. This is Owen Morrison looking off. He sees his target, puts the cross in. Arteaga just puts it by to Costa, who's coming out, kind of got caught flat-footed there for the goal. But look at this one. Oh, there it is into the upper 90. What a shot. No stopping that. His second goal of the game, fourth of the year. Now Morrison off Don Smart. He's trying to get a second assist of the game. Carson Smith coming up at the end. And there it is. George Dublin back in action for Antigua, saving that ball from another goal.
And while Barracuda have had chances, they've only had two shots on goal. And the only three corners of the first half favor New York. Well, the second half awaits. Can Barracuda FC bite into that 2-0 deficit? Find out next. The USL Pro Game of the Week continues here on Fox Soccer right after this timeout.
The legendary New York Cosmos are back, and to mark the club's rebirth, Umbro has applied its celebrated football tailoring ethos to the brand new 2011 collection. Anthem jacket, Cosmos tees, New York Cosmos jersey, 1976-1977 home jersey. For the complete New York Cosmos line, go to soccer.com/Umbro.
Nothing like seeing the beautiful game in stunning high definition. And there's nothing like watching the biggest new DVD releases on breathtaking Blu-ray. Bring home the best in home entertainment with the Sylvania HD LCD flat screen.
That is the way to do it!
And the outstanding Sylvania Blu-ray disc player. Available today at these stores.
Thanks to the Venture Card from Capital One, we get double miles on every purchase. So me and the boys earned a trip to DC twice as fast.
Oh, hi.
We get double miles every time we use our card. And since double miles add up fast,
one more chariot, please.
We can bring the whole gang.
I cannot tell a lie. He did it.
Right. It's hard to beat double miles.
Read my lips. No new access.
Get the Venture Card from Capital One and earn double miles on every purchase every day. Go to CapitalOne.com.
What's in your wallet? So you're a Democrat, right?
Tomorrow, it's Soccer Night in America on Fox Soccer. The pressure is on as DC United look to rally up the Eastern Conference. Can Philly shut down the United Strike Force? DC United, Philadelphia Union, live tomorrow on Fox Soccer.
Is it so wrong for man to love cars? In some states, maybe.
But I don't care. I'm a gearhead.
That's why I'm hosting the car show, where we talk, live, and breathe everything cars.
The Car Show, coming July 13th to Speed.
You are watching FSC in HD.
This broadcast of USL Pro is brought to you by USLsoccer.com. Scores, stats, news, and more exclusively on USLsoccer.com, the official website of United Soccer Leagues. By Umbro, true to soccer since 1924. For more information, visit umbro.com. By the PDL, the Premier Development League, providing a pathway to the professional game. And by the W League, the first and longest running national women's soccer league in North America.
Well, we're here in New York tonight, but Soccer Night in America tomorrow night has DC United against the Philadelphia Union at 6:30 Eastern Time, live in HD. And then next week, it's the Galaxy and the Fire. It's on Saturday the 9th on Soccer Night in America, Major League Soccer. Let's go down to Jason right before the start of the second half. Jason.
Thanks, guys. I spoke with both coaches at halftime, and they both said the same thing. And it's exactly what I saw down here at field level as well. The teams are just giving the ball away too easy down here. They need to settle in. They need to keep the ball, knock it around a little bit, and see what they can create. Now, this game is far from over. One goal in either direction can change the outcome of this game very quickly. Guys.
Thank you, Jason. Well, Tom Curtis has gone to his bench with Karanya Mack coming in to replace Kamarley McDonald at the back. And then Lawson Robinson replacing Kamoy Alexander in the midfield. So two of his five substitutions as we begin the second half of play here at Belson Stadium on the campus of St. John's University in Jamaica, New York. Now it's FC New York, still in the blue and white, but now they're attacking from right to left across your screen here in the second half. It's Holder. Ball rides out of play on the far side.
You know, it's an interesting sub of the left side because I thought that McDonald had done a fairly good job with Holder, containing him and not allowing him to get by him. So now it's up to Mack to see if he can do the same. FC New York went right at that side as well. They are right there.
And Mack lost that one over the touch line on the far side. Here you see Owen Morrison, whose wondrous goal at Red Bull Arena on Tuesday gave FC New York the lead against New York Red Bulls, only to see Hans Bacca's crew equalize and then take the victory. And the flag is up there as Don Smart headed toward the goal. So now we'll see what the opening few minutes here hold in store for Antigua Barracuda FC as they try to cut into this 2-0 deficit. Got a couple of new players on the pitch. David Reed sent that one up. There's Owen Morrison. We'll come here to Smart on the near side. Smart with some space. As Arteaga has an option, but he puts it back to Roach in the midfield.
Yeah, unfortunately, Arteaga was his only forward option there. He had really no choice but to come back.
Too strong in the touch there by Arteaga. Puts it out of play on the near side. Seen Smart get forward a few times.
Yeah, she was trying to get behind the defender that time. He was really needed, you know, the short support there for Arteaga.
Now, I know as a coach, you feel comfortable with a 2-0 lead, but what do you do to protect that lead?
Well, I think the number one thing is you have to play safe in the back. And I don't mean that you're luffing the ball out, but, you know, something like that. You give a giveaway in the back half of the field, it's going to give some confidence to the other team. But the best way to sit on a lead, in my opinion, is to get a third goal. And, you know, we see the slide tackle out of bounds. And
Orlando Mitchum getting introduced to their Umbro signboard.
But I really think, especially, playing at home, you be smart and careful. You certainly know that you can create chances. I think the issue that I would have addressed at halftime to FC New York is the defensive side of things. Just keep doing the same stuff we're doing on the attack, but we have to get ourselves better defensively, better compact. Because there really were, there was only a couple shots on goal for Antigua, there certainly were chances.
Diaz now had a nasty collision. At least it was nasty if you were Kamoy Alexander. Late in that first half, Alexander has since left the match. Now the crowd again brings itself to life. And since Arteaga's two goals in a 3-minute span in the first half, their team has been calmly possessing the ball, but haven't given them a lot to really get excited about.
No, really, just that corner kick that caught Carson Smith at the back post where he had a chance. It was cleared off the line by George Dublin.
Here you see Lawson Robinson pushing forward. This is why he's inserted into the match, to be able to venture forward, and he wins the first corner of the match for Antigua Barracuda FC.
Yeah, it was a good job there, and it's a reason you put subs in is to make your team better. Right now they need to get a goal, and they get it right away or get it before too long. That just changes the whole complex of the game, as Jason said.
It's a deep throw in rather than a corner. Lofted into the box. Turning, firing, saved by Steven Diaz.
It was a good cross. There was only one player for Antigua standing there with any chance to get on the end of that. And certainly once you're getting into an attacking spot, you need to commit players in there when you're down right now 2-0.
They launched that one long, trying to get it to Don Smart, who had snuck in there. He was onside, but the ball ran out of play on the near side. Ball driven out of the back there by Karsten Smith. Now here's Ronda Christian. Loses it here on the near side, and Smart will let it ride out. To Marley Thomas on his back. It looks like Paul Shaw may be going to his bench for the first time. And here's the guy Jason was talking about right before kickoff. Teddy Otero is going to replace Michael Aquino. Told you about this rookie and what a fine season he has had, leading the league with 5 assists.
Yeah, he's a quality player. Played here at St. John's, another one of the players. I think we got 3 players on the field right now that played for Dave Mazur's team. And, Michael Aquino, who went out of the game, is a good player, but he really didn't say his name, did we, in the first half? He just was not involved.
Well, Tom Curtis, a couple of options off his bench, and so Paul Shaw answers with another creative attacking player, but it's going to be Barracuda here with an attacking free kick.
Well, I said it in the first half, but I'm about taking a shot from this distance. They're a bit closer right now, and I certainly would expect that we'll see the same sort of attempt on target as we saw before. It's the same setup for Antigua.
Quentin Griffith stands over this ball.
You gotta challenge Diaz and get in on rebounds.
Griffith will try to bring this dead ball to life. He pushes it forward into the box. Diaz out, and it's cleared off the line.
Karsten Smith backing up Diaz to clear that ball out. That was a very clever free kick. Fooled everybody. Look at this, just running right by. Beats everybody in that side. Caught FC New York sleeping, and well done to Karsten Smith to back up the keeper.
And now we will see Barracuda's first corner kick of the evening. Swerved in low and hard and cleared away.
Those are deflating corner kicks when it doesn't get past the first defender. You got to give yourselves a chance. You know, we don't, you know, as we say, the report on Diaz is that he doesn't always come off his line too well, so get that ball out there and challenge him in the air.
Diaz has the ball at his feet right now, and a 2-0 lead here in the 54th minute. Roy Gregory got his foot to that one for Antigua Barracuda FC. But New York has it back. To Smart into the center circle. Smartly plays it back. Smith goes back to Diaz. And Diaz will get to do it all over again. Here's Arteaga. Roy Gregory stepped in there and won a throw in for his team.
I don't think you got Arteaga for knocking him right
Fouled
before,
him
that.
Right before
yeah.
that.
Yeah, well, it wasn't really much of anything there, but he got him for it. I think this FC New York has to be careful about just going into these long direct balls. You know, they had a fair bit of success in the first half moving the ball around. You know, if you can lose confidence in yourselves if all of a sudden you're only keeping it one or two passes and all of a sudden you're defending again. You know, they've got the ability to keep the ball like they're doing there. You just got to lay that off. There's no need to play around with it.
And we've seen Barracuda can strike or at least develop a chance out of nothing pretty quickly, and all they need is one bit of magic, and they're right back in this game. Trailing 2-0. Just about reached 55 minutes played here at Belson Stadium. At St. John's University, Jamaica, New York, Ken Tomash, Keith Tabasnik, former University of Maryland standout Jason Arnold. Talked about your bad memories of this place. Jason, as a Maryland Terrapin, has some bad memories of St. John's as well. He played in three college cups while with the Terps. Doing great work on the touch lines for us. And now you see that pressure stepped up by Barracuda, putting the pressure on the back four of New York and forcing them to try to keep possession, and they couldn't do it there.
You know, and they have to step up. This is you know, the exciting part about games. You know, they have to chase this game. They have to be careful how they do it, because if they open up too much, you know, you're gonna New York will be able to send people through. But again, they should have had enough confidence from the half chances or deep chances that they had in the first half that they can get a goal.
Speaking of Jason Arnold, let's go down to Jason for more from the FC New York side of things.
The New York Red Bulls that has a special USL connection. Juan Agudelo, he starred for the U.S. national team at the recent CONCACAF Gold Cup, but he started his climb to the pro ranks with the New Jersey Junior Stallion squad that played in the 2006 Super Y League North American Finals. Agudelo earned a spot on that all-tournament team. He was invited to the USL Super Y League National ODP camp, and then 2 years later, he was invited to the under-17 men's national team residency program in Bradenton, Florida. Guys?
Thank you, Jason. And you know, four of Agudelo's U.S. teammates at the Gold Cup also got their starts in the Super Y League, including Josie Aldador, Freddie Adu, Jonathan Spector, and Eric Lehigh. It is the nation's first national elite youth league, and it's dedicated to the progression of the top players in America. And the Super Y League ODP programs also opened a lot of doors for players to get identified for U.S. national teams.
No, absolutely, and it's part of the pyramid that USL has going. And you know, you talk about the Super 20 League, the Super Y League, PDL, and leading into USL Pro, and we've seen all the different players that have moved on. You know, looking at a stat recently, 69% of the players taken in the 2011 MLS Super Draft played in the PDL, including 8 of the first 10. That's a remarkable stat. I really think that the PDL and Super Y are just filling such a big need that we have for the development of the game in our country.
Well, Paul Shaw, as we said, has 5 of his first 11, including Steven Diaz, back in goal, who formerly played in the PDL. Diaz played for the Brooklyn Knights, Metropolitan Oval. Here we have kind of an international flavor, not just because we have two teams here representing two different countries, but very diverse fan base here, and some of the world's best clubs are coming over to these shores to play games against USL Pro this summer, just this month, actually. Portsmouth is gonna visit Charleston near the end of the month, and Orlando City this month is gonna host both Bolton Wanderers and Newcastle United in the span of a week, so very aggressive and very interesting week that Adrian Heath and company are gonna have in mid-July. It's a curling ball. The shot by the substitute, Teddy Otero.
Yeah, he hit that well, and keeping it well to keep up with it too, because he had to have been screened on it. But yeah, we're talking about those international teams. There's also the partnerships, you know, between the USL teams and other pro teams that have really been, you know, Harrisburg City Islanders benefiting right now with affiliation with the Philadelphia Union. Those sort of things, so important. It really opens up doors for players. And you know, the international games, you can't beat it. You know, be able to go and watch Newcastle play. Like that with such a strong history and tradition.
Push that one forward to Arteaga. You talk about the best players from all over the world, and we've got players from many different countries here in the field today, but it's a kid from the New York area who's been the star, Jhonny Arteaga, with a pair of goals in the first half. And as we've just about reached the hour mark, his team leads by that 2-0 margin. There's Barracuda looking for more. Lawson Robinson, second half substitute. Plays it up to Merrily Thomas. Griffith will play it wide. Oh, and rough first touch there by Mack. Goes out of play, but Tom Curtis staying positive. Knows that just one little chance here could really change this match.
That's one of the things with the Barracuda is that quite often they've shown, you know, a little bit of rhythm going, playing some balls, and then it has been just like the bad touch from Mack that has kind of stopped the momentum.
Now Smith. Paul Shaw is going to go to his bench again for his second sub. Next opportunity. That one is launched long, and some pressure put on there by Terra. Morrison back to Roach. Is it wide to Smart, and a little too wide on this turf field? And we're going to see Sam Stockley come into the match. He's going to replace Eric Rengifo in the 61st minute. Sam Stockley, a veteran with wars overseas as well. And a foul called over on the far side on New York. And Stockley will come in and wear the captain's armband as well.
Yes, you know, it's an interesting sub in the fact that you don't often sub for guys in your back line. Now, both teams have done that. And, you know, none of the players have been playing poor.
Here's a dangerous ball in the box. Diaz has to come out again. Try to punch it. Then he tried to do Kung Fu Panda on it. As he was outside of the box, his initial try was with the hands, but then he found himself outside the box. Now he finds himself down on his hands and knees inside the box.
There was some contact, and I'll tell you what, that certainly was not textbook on how you do things. And have a look at this again. Diaz coming out to punch it. Punches it right down. He thinks he's going to go again. It might have been a fake. You know, fake like you're going to catch the ball in the... you know, karate kick it out of there. But I'd love to hear Peter Mellor's opinion on that. Outstanding goalkeeper, probably. I'm not sure. I'm sure I could picture Peter doing that.
Well, definitely not. He's a man in his 60s, Keith.
But I'll tell you what, that's a little unusual. And by the way, it ended up being an open net if it took a little bit more care with the following up. It almost looked like it was a very hard chance, but it really wasn't as hard as it looked.
Less than half an hour left in this one, and Barracuda has had some opportunities to get that first goal that might get them over the hump. Each team has made two substitutions. Diaz has kept a clean sheet to this point. It's not been without its moments of drama. Almost a giveaway there, but Lawson Robinson has it for Barracuda FC. Puts that one forward for Burton. And launched forward, too far for Christian, who may have been offside anyway.
If FC New York can keep this up, you know, it'll be an impressive run that they've had. It would be seven games with only one loss, and they're certainly climbing up the ladder and putting themselves in a good spot to try to make the playoffs. So top four teams, each division, get to advance.
Well, right now they've got a 2-point lead over Pittsburgh for the last playoff spot in the National Division, but they've also got two games in hand on the Riverhounds. And after tonight, only 10 games left. You're getting to the part of the season where you want to be playing your best soccer, heading towards the end of the regular season in about 6 weeks' time.
There's no question. You're past the time where you're trying to sort things out. If you're still trying to sort things out, you're probably in a lot of trouble at this stage.
It drops over Hoffer's head. He'll head that one back to Steven Diaz. Played forward, picked off by Lawson Robinson. New York has it back. It's Karsten Smith. David Reed. Again, they look for Arteaga. Christopher Harvey got there first. This game needs a boost. Who will provide it? Marley Thomas thought about it. Try to work the give and go. Here's Thomas again into the box. Diaz out, makes the save. Randolph Burton with the point blank shot. Now Burton's down at the edge of the six.
Yeah, he's down. An excellent give and go by Antigua. We'll watch this again. Cleverly played there. This is what Diaz is good at. He is an excellent line keeper. He's showing you right there. Excellent reflexes, holding his ground as long as he could, and certainly taking away the best chance that Antigua has had all night. You know, you can win the games on both ends of the field, and you never know whether that's the key play.
Kwame Holder now drops it back to Karsten Smith. Here to David Reed. Here's Tara. He's been injected into this match to be creative. Maybe provide another spark for a New York attack that, since the 17th minute, has not produced any goals. New York's now just scored just 14 goals on the season. Probably none more impressive than Arteaga's second that rocketed off the underside of the crossbar and down.
Certainly, those are the ones that you try to hit every time you're in practice.
This time Arteaga drops it off to Smart. Here's Dublin clearing for Barracuda. Morrison muscled out of the way by Griffith.
I think one of the things I liked about that goal too was just excellent technique. It's not like you went up there. You look like he was trying to hit it as hard as he possibly could. He just struck it nice and clean.
Now it's Roach. One touched on by Morrison. Oh, and you could see Arteaga hesitate. Am I on? Am I off? The flag went up.
Yeah, flag went up, and it was too casual a play by Morrison as well. And it was a sloppy flick on, and you know, even if he's onside, boy, that's going to be a tough ball to deal with. And he actually had behind him Tadeo Terra. Could have left the ball for him. He would have been right into goal.
So Tom Curtis is going to go to his bench again and bring on Stefan Smith, their leading goal scorer. And boy, could they use one here. So Randolph Burton checks out in the 68th minute. Stefan Smith, number 9.
He's got five goals on the year, 12 caps, 5 goals also for the national team. In fact, this is Stefan Smith's debut season for his club, his first club, Old Road FC in Antigua, 17 goals in his debut season.
Well, that's what his side needs right now. Here's a goal. Let's check in on what's been going on around the rest of the league. Has anybody else come up with any scores? Not in Pittsburgh, where Orlando City and the Riverhounds finished in a 0-0 draw. Also, Los Angeles and Charleston. The Blues get a point on the road. And Rochester beats Richmond up in Rochester 2-1. So the Rhinos extend their lead at the top of the division. They came in with a 3-point edge over Harrisburg. So now move that to 6 points. And it's now 13 points over New York. Well, Pittsburgh picking up a point. They close to within a point of New York, so it's... They're not scoreboard watching, obviously, but if they can get the result here tonight, that will further solidify their place.
You know, the perhaps. Interesting about the teams that make the playoffs is FC New York ends up making the playoffs after, not the best start to the season, but if they make the playoffs, they are gelling. Just what you said before, teams have to get into their best at this stage and be playing their best a month from now. And the fact that they're that many points behind Rochester really won't make that big a difference if they continue to make this progress.
Right, and they might face the Rhinos in that first round of the playoffs as that one goes out over to the far side. We are at Belson Stadium, campus of St. John's University, and those Antigua Barracuda fans desperately hoping that time will not run out on them. Only about 20 minutes left in this one. They are keeping hope alive. Barracuda, who told you scored 23 goals in the season. We got a foul in the box, and we're going to go back the other way. It's 23 goals, second most in the league to Orlando's 26. Can they find one here in the final 20 minutes and change? Andre Christian hasn't been able to find the back of the net yet, but Stefan Smith, their leading scorer, has just been inserted as a substitute.
Hope that gives them the spark they need. Christian has 2 goals and 1 assist, trying to find himself open in the box there, pushing out.
So Gary Boughton is going to come in now for New York in the 71st minute. Owen Morrison leaves after a quiet evening. Started a nice chance in the first half.
Had a good cross for the first goal and a very good cross off the corner kick that Carson Smith almost got on the end of as well. But again, not as involved as he needs to be in the type of player that can connect and keep the possession going for.
Now Barracuda again races onto this one. Diaz likes to come out, sometimes dangerously so. And Christian unable to keep that one in play. Good work by the FC New York back line to not panic at the back.
Yeah, we'll see this again here because it's Carson Smith making a good play after trying, after a bad play earlier. He was trying to push that ball away. I think he kind of hesitated when Diaz came out calling for the ball. Comes off it, but he stays with it and gets it out of the area and safe. And again, we're still seeing on both sides just the communication between the goalkeepers and their backs. And they've had a couple of mistakes. And was certainly costly for Antigua early in the game. 14th minute goal by Jhonny Arteaga, to be followed 3 minutes later by one of the goals of the year.
And we talked about Diaz firmly grabbing that starting keeper role. The New Yorkers have used a few different keepers here in their inaugural season, but if Diaz keeps playing the way he has, he'll do one of two things. He'll They'll continue to get results, or Paul Shaw will lose what's left of his hair if he keeps coming out sometimes in some of those.
Yeah, I must add a couple keepers like that over the years.
Now Diaz with no pressure on him. In the 73rd minute, launches this one across midfield. Arteaga tries to spin away from it. Terra with it, drops it to Arteaga. Getting there for Barracuda. Here's Gregory. Now foul in the midfield here.
Yeah, it was a foul too. And again, it was just a little over aggressive for Carson Smith. It's an area of the field. No need to foul. Go off the hook. Just be with him. Make him play back. Yeah, this is something they deserve. The game last week and this week, a lot of those fouls coming from the backs when they don't need to.
Harvey's long ball is cleared away by Smith at the top of the 18. And now it's New York coming back the other way. Smart. Terra. Terra to the edge of the box. Toe pokes it forward and it's headed out of the box. Terra will track it down here though.
Clever pass by Terra, almost caught.
Now.
Almost caught the forward going in there. Arteaga.
There he was looking to the far side to Kwame Holder, but Barracuda will track it down on that far side. Bring it up now. Griffith launches it long, headed back the other way by Hoffer. 50-50 ball on the far side touchline. Goes out of play. Mack will throw it in for Barracuda. 74th minute. Gregory will touch that one nicely over his opponent's head. And toe poke it forward. Here's Stefan Smith, but he can't get past Kyle Hoffer. He's been stalwart at the back tonight.
Again, I think it's an excellent partnership building between Hoffer and Smith. Two young players that are certainly given a bright future. Paul Shaw's got to be happy with that.
It was Terra trying to spin away from Gregory, but by the time he got there, Harvey had it on the back line for Barracuda. This is Christopher Harvey. Stefan Smith got elbow in the back of the head, courtesy of Karsten Smith. There comes Stephen Roach in to clean up that mess, put it out of play. Roy Gregory to take the throw on the near side. Right back out off a defender for another throw. There's David Reed mixing it up there on the touch line. Here's Arteaga. Launches it forward and Matt gets there. Goalkeeper falls down. Will this be 3-0? Oh, this time it's off the underside of the post and it doesn't go in.
That was almost another goal off the woodwork. And again, there's another bad mistake. We said there's a suspect of those mistakes. First happened in the midfield with another poor square ball that just led to the counterattack.
It was Gary Boughton who thought he had the third goal. And denied by the crossbar. Back at the other end, Barracuda still looking for that first goal in the 77th minute. And the flag is up.
That was a good ball. Have another look at that down at the other end. And you see another ball hitting the crossbar. This one not going in, but goalkeeper DeCastro could not handle that. And then the ball off the crossbar. And so just an inch away from making this game 3-0.
Adventures in goalkeeping at both ends of the pitch.
I think that's the way to put it. That could be your lead in your breakaway magazine, because I know we're going to see the one goal on that magazine feature for sure.
77th minute here. FC New York leads Antigua Barracuda FC 2-0. Ken Tomasz, Keith Tabatnik, and Jason Arnold with you from Belson Stadium on the campus of St. John's University, Jamaica, New York.
and it's great to be able to see these games and so many games this year on Fox Soccer. Also, 100 games on USLLive.com. Comprehensive broadcast package that we have on Fox Soccer, Game of the Week, USL Breakaway magazines, really bringing the fans a lot closer to the passion, excitement, and tradition that lives with USL Pro. And I say this because it's a lot of hard work to put all that together, and it helps in every facet of the game to be able to have these games available to see, whether it's live on TV or whether it's on the web.
And it'll really give you an idea when you see not only the breadth of the coverage, but the quality of play that USL Pro is the strongest, most sophisticated, and most experienced North American men's professional soccer league below MLS, both on and off the field. We're seeing some great action on the field tonight with New York leading 2-0. Reed gets through. Top of the box, Smart back to Reed. Left foot's one across, and it's cleared away by Antigua. Before it can get to Keita De Castro.
There's a nice clever pass by Smart here. Just laying it off right in behind. Antigua defender trying to pull him off sides. It wasn't, gets in. It's Reed again getting far from his left back position.
Now Reed is back in the center circle. He tracks this one down as it skips back into the FC New York end, the 79th minute. Can Stefan Smith add to his team-leading total of 5 goals and get Barracuda on the board? Had some opportunities, but no real clear, strong chances on Steven Diaz in a while.
Well, I must say, as I was saying in the first half, I'm a bit surprised that they haven't been able to get a goal. Obviously, they had that one outstanding chance that Diaz made an excellent save on. And, you know, that ball goes in. It's a one-goal game, and we're probably seeing a different thing happening out here right now. It'd be all on one end of the field.
Well, New York leads it 2-0 in the 80th minute, and they will host the Charlotte Eagles here on Sunday as Arteaga dancing in the box. Pushes it back up to Terra. Holder now floats this one. Just over the bar. Oh my gosh. Keita De Castro definitely making things interesting and keeping our audience glued to their sets here.
There was a clever back heel by Terra, and this cross, if it had gone in, would have given Terra his 6th assist. Even though it was not intended as a shot, it almost caught De Castro.
Corner kick here for New York, their 4th of the match. Come from the near side flag. And we've got a foul in the box and go back the other way. I started to say that Charlotte will be here on the 4th of July on Monday. And the Eagles are not only terrific on the field, they've been hot lately. They have a lot of dedication off the field too. The Eagles organization is a great example of this with their Urban Eagles project. Jason has more on that, Jason.
The players from the Charlotte Eagles USL Pro Squad, they actually live in some of the roughest neighborhoods in Charlotte. They help build the community from within, and they act as mentors to the kids in the neighborhood. It's remarkable how much effort and time they're putting into helping their community. It's really as much as they're putting in to voting, preparing to each game each week. But, you know, these guys aren't out there giving them an hour a week or an hour a month. They're living in these neighborhoods, and they're giving their time day in and day out. It's quite amazing, actually.
And guys, you can get the full story on the Urban Eagles Project Monday at 7:30 Eastern. As the next edition of USL Breakaway Magazine comes your way here on Fox Soccer. Hear all about the Urban Eagles project, as well as we'll talk with Tim Ream, U.S. national teamer. Got his start in USL, and now we've got Nabil Al Saadi racing back to try to make sure that nothing erupts late in this match with New York leading 2-0. I was having a talk with Karsten Smith.
Yeah, well, Karsten has had a couple of fouls right from the beginning of the game, right the way through, and he wants to make sure nothing happens as we go into the final part.
Theo Brown comes in the 82nd minute, replacing Tamarley Thomas.
It's only his second appearance this season for Brown.
sent goalward as well, up high in the air, headed towards Diaz's goal, and he scoops that one up. So Tom Curtis has just one sub left to make, and not a lot of time left to make it if he wants to do so.
They need to be a little bit more alert there because they allowed Diaz to put the foot on the ball and have some precious seconds off the clock. Those seconds are valuable. You get a goal and you want them at the end, injury time, and you know, anything can happen. A team that's able to score goals can certainly score two.
Smart, and that shot goes high and wide by Fountain. Fountain's had a couple of chances since coming into this match in the 71st minute. And you know, started with a giveaway at the back.
Yeah, sorry, you notice there too, as the Blues are going down, there wasn't too many players in the dark shirts in the back there. They have to stay organized because while you're chasing this game, you know, 7 minutes plus injury time, and it's enough time to score goals, but certainly you give up number three, it's all done.
Again on the back line for New York. They've kept a clean sheet to this point. And the flag is up on the far side.
Arteaga is going to wonder how he could have been offside from there, but he made a run. He had never got himself back from the last attack and made quite a run back to try to get that ball. It's just the referee got that right.
Here's Mack coming forward, and his left-footed shot goes off his opposite number and out of play, and both teams are saying that they've got it. It's going to be a New York throw-in. See Sam Stockley, who came in the 61st minute and assumed the captain's role. Now here's Barracuda. Push this one through again, and Diaz is there with a little help from his friend Karsten Smith. So will it be back-to-back shutouts at home in the league for Steven Diaz? He shut out the Richmond Kickers here last week. And about 6 minutes and change away from doing the same here against one of the higher scoring teams in the league.
And he had some saves against Richmond, similar to the one that we saw about 15 minutes ago in this game.
It's Quinton Griffith. Lawson Robinson. Sent one forward to Orlando Mitchum. Now here's Roy Gregory pushing up. Couldn't get that one going anywhere, went off defender. Tries to push it around Terra and does. Gregory now floats it to the near post, but just hits that side netting. We're going to see Bradley Welch come in. So Jhonny Arteaga's night is done, but what a night it was. Two goals, including a highlight reel strike for the second goal. And in the 86th, he's replaced by Bradley Welch.
Yeah, certainly Arteaga showed a lot. I mean, he's got a lot of raw talent out there. And I think the coach's staff really likes what he has to offer. Maybe scoring these two goals is just going to propel him for this last part of the season, the next 10 games. And you know, you need players that you can put your rest on, that you can go to for the goals. And with Brito out, great for Arteaga to step up.
Griffith pushed that one forward. Hoffer is there. Diaz comes out to his 18 to clear it out to midfield. And goes off the hip, Bradley Welch, the latest substitute into this match. Be out here on the near side, but it will be a throw for FC New York. To Roach. 87th minute. Here's Terra now, sliding that one to Reed, who's pushed up. Reed again at the edge of the box, sent that one a little too far to the other side. Boughton is there though. Knocked away from him. Collision on the far side, and that's a push there in the back by Theo Brown.
I tell you, kind of love that ball by Terra. Well, just split the defenders and made both defenders have to turn, face their own goal. Another excellent run in behind, and you know, smart. You know, they needed to get that cross, you know, to give them a chance.
There's another cross into the box, headed away by Barracuda. Back by Stockley. Stolen away now by Terra. Barracuda just can't hold on to the ball and get anything going. Again sent across. Holder with a diving header, and it's sent over the end line.
Yeah, I think Holder was so anxious to get into the middle of the goal that he ended up having to backtrack. Actually might have been a little more patient at the back. He would have been able to run right on top of that. As we say, FC New York is certainly not just sitting back and, you know, knocking the ball out and letting the clock go down. They're trying to get goal number three still right at the end.
Griffith plays it forward. Barracuda has a long way to go and a short time to get there. We're in the 88th minute. Gregory slides that one forward. Austin Robinson doesn't have it for long at the edge of the box. Gregory again, edge of the box. Will it come here? Not right there, it won't. Orlando Mitchum had a chance, but that FC New York defense just clamped down on him again. Now it's Kwame Holder in a 50-50 challenge. Christopher Harvey goes out of play, and quickly New York throws it right back in. Terra. Oh, he megged him. Smart. Oh, he hit that way too hard.
Boy, he tried to go for the highlight goal there. And that's all he was thinking. Boy, that was teed up for him, wasn't it? Again, all from the work of Terra as well. Have another look at this. It's fortunate. The ball just laid off by accident from the Antigua defenders. And well, he just strike that good technique, and you got a goal out of it. Here, they'll get another try here with Terra.
Terra again, dispossessed by Griffith. He'll be knocked up into the seats here. Reed to throw it in. To Welch. Now Smart. Smart play back into the center circle to Hoffer. All the way back to Diaz. Almost reached 90 minutes. Roach called off his mates. Here's Boughton to Holder. Griffith muscles him out of the way. Holder goes back and just will not be denied. Did foul his man, though. We've reached 90 minutes. 2 minutes of stoppage time.
Here's going these last 2 minutes, Ken. You know, just a thought here that the Antigua team and the fans in Antigua need to be happy, despite what will likely end up being the loss, happy with their team. And you know, they show some flashes of some really exciting play. They just need to be more consistent on the ball. And there were some bad giveaways, and obviously safer in the back. You know, but it was just a 3 minute spurt there that deciding factor in the game.
Good professional result by New York, which will move to 3-1-3 under Paul Shaw. After a 1-4-2 start, here's Stefan Smith. Hasn't gotten many touches since he came into the match, and he dawdled a little bit too long on that one. Set forward, looking for Welch. It'll go over his head. And Dublin has to play it back. Final minute of stoppage time. Roach wins that one. To Gregory, who's pushed up. Is there late drama here at all to change the final score, if not the result? Robinson ripped the left footer wide.
Robinson did what most of the shots for Antigua have done. They've just gone high and wide. Only a couple on target testing Diaz. And he was up to the task.
Looks like Steven Diaz will keep another clean sheet. Get And a well-deserved result. Watches this goal kick skyward across midfield, headed back the other way by Mack. Roach sees that one drop behind him. Only seconds remain. Here's Barracuda. Pushed to the edge of the box. It's sent wide, and that's into the side netting.
What an excellent cross there, and getting wide open at the back post as well.
Theo Brown, the late substitute.
Yeah, he was just ghosting in the back instead of getting in too early, able to come onto that ball. So needs to put that across the face of the goal, and they would have got a goal back.
This may be the final act of this match. Steven Diaz milking it. And that is it. FC New York behind two goals by that man, Jhonny Arteaga. Win it for Keith Tabatsnik, Jason Arnold, and our entire Fox Soccer crew. I'm Ken Tomash wishing you good night from New York, where FC New York wins it 2-0. See you next week.